This time we are going to discuss about access classes. A number of times people are always curious to ask what happens, how an operator gives priority to one user over the other. Do you use a platinum package or do you use a gold package or do you use a bronze package, so on and so forth. Now we are not going to discuss about all those subscription and differentiated services an operator offers, but what we are going to discuss is in idle mode, how certain users can get more priority over the other users. In connected mode, there can be different priorities, but that's a topic of discussion for some other time. Right now, we are going to discuss how access classes can be used to prioritize one subscriber over the other. And as you see on the screen, it says access classes. So you see, it says ordinary classes ranging from 0 to 9, while special categories ranging from 11 to 15. 11 represents PLM and staff, while 12 represents security services if you're an FBI agent or if you're a CIA agent, etc., or any other specific personnel, you may be given this access class. Then public utilities, it may be given people who are responding to medical staff, so on and so forth, or any other public utility services, city services may get this access class, so on and so forth. And 14 for emergency services. Now, the question to ask is, okay, how these access classes will help or how these access classes are going to give priority to one user over the other, so on and so forth, and where does ordinary users fall and come into play? So to answer this simple question, what we need to understand is in idle mode, UEs are camping onto a cell. And let me draw a scenario here, which will help us to understand it in a much better way. So let's say this is a site. And on this site, we have three users who are camping. And I'll just consider example for three users which are camping. And then you can get the idea with this example. So let's say these three users, one of the user is James. Another user we have here is with their smartphone. This other user is Mike. And then the third user we have in this scenario is Ryan. So Ryan in this case, let's say, is a security agent and his UE is camping onto the cell. Mike, on the other hand, is an ordinary subscriber and James is PLM and staff. Now the question is, what happens if the network is too busy while they're camping onto the site? All these three UEs are camping onto the cell, and then a time comes in when all of them want to go from idle to connected mode. Let's say at the same instance, they want to go from idle to connected mode. They want to make a call or use any specific service. And let's say the system is already loaded. So will they all three be treated in the same way, or will someone will be given preference over the other? This is where access classes come into play. And the idea here is simple. Those users who are ordinary users, they will not get the same access class as compared to other users, in this case the PLM and staff or security agent or any other access classes. In a normal scenario, all of them may access the network at the same time, but let's say if the network is busy and it cannot accommodate all three of them at the same time, then system is going to give preference to these specific other subscriber, James, and other user, in this case Ryan. So how does it happen? In this case, we have timers T305 and T307, and the way those timers are calculated, that depends on the access class barring, depends on the barring factor and the time which has been specified. So it's not that you will have to wait. Remember, I want to emphasize and clarify, it does not mean that ordinary user Mike will not be able to access the network. In fact, this user will have to make an attempt later on after James and Ryan can get connected. So let's say if access classes are actively happening and the other users are given priority, so let's say if all three of them are making access attempt, James and Ryan may get access to the network right away, whereas Mike's UE will have to wait for a certain amount of time depending on whatever is the timer value T305 or T307, which is computed based on those access class barring factor and barring time. T307 or T305, depending on if it's signaling access or if it is data access. And the formula for this one, we will talk about this. Now, this user who has to wait, this wait time is actually given to this ordinary user so that other users can use the resources and do their respective tasks. And when the time expires, then when the user will make an attempt, that user will have access to resources and then it will get connected. So that's the overall idea of access classes. And once, as long as the user has to wait, it will consider that the cell is barred. Barred does not mean that the user is being blocked. It just means that user will have to wait for a certain amount of time. Now, cell barring does not mean that it's not equivalent to if someone has been blocked and so on and so forth. It just means someone is barred for a certain amount of time. So it does not even mean that the cell is reserved. These are two different terminologies, and that's why this table I have listed on the screen for you, that there is a difference between cell barring and cell being reserved. Cell barring can take place on a cell which, in case of cell selection, reselection, or using resources, whereas for reserved, the definition is shown at the bottom. And if a cell is barred, it may not be allowed to select a cell for a certain amount of time depending on the timer. So you may be wondering, okay, what are the factors which will decide how long the cell will be barred? And the answer to this question is, it depends what is the purpose for making an attempt. Is it a mobile originating call? Is it a mobile originated signaling call? Or is it a mobile originated data call? Depending on those specific reasons, whatever is the cause, the UE is trying to make attempt, the timers will vary. And the timers actually depend on these factors, which can have value either of the two. If it's a mobile originated signaling call, then the factors barring factor, barring time, and barring for special access classes is listed over here. Similarly, for mobile originated data, the barring factor, barring time, and special barring for special access classes is listed over here. The range for barring time can be ranging from 4 seconds all the way up to 512 seconds. And the barring factor is the factor which ranges from 0 to 0.95 or up to 95%. How the timer is calculated, that depends on these factors over here. Now, this one was from the perspective of normal mobile originated signaling or mobile originated data call. With the advent of voice services over LTE or IMS services, what happens if a user wants to make a phone call right away using IMS? Will that be barred as well, or should that be given a different, a special privileged access from going from idle to connected mode? The barring for that case is different. Special access services, as you can see, for MMTEL voice and MMTEL video, the parameters are different. And similarly for CS fallback, the access class barring parameters are different. So it depends on the operator. If they want to bar specific users and give them a priority even to ordinary users for voice services or video services or CS fallback, the parameters are given here. Now, I know you are curious, what is the formula based on which can we calculate the time, how long UE will have to wait before they can access the network or a barred cell. So the timer, its inclusion of these parameters, as well as how it's computed, and most importantly, the exercise is related to this specific access class I have included in the exercise PDF. So go ahead and download that particular PDF, and then based on that PDF, go through these exercises before we go to the next video.